What's up, people of the internet? I'm the Big Bold here with yet another video. In this video, we'll be testing the Intel Celeron H840, which is a CPU based on the Silver Mount architecture and part of the Bejeweled family of power efficient processors. It has 2 cores and 2 threads, and it has a frequency of up to 2.58 GHz. The Celeron H840 has the Intel HD Graphics Bejeweled as the integrated graphics, which have 4 unified shaders and a frequency of up to 792 MHz in the H840's case. It's also based on the Intel HD 4000 architecture, or using the latest drivers for it available. We also have 4GB of RAM in single channel mode, as well as a 500GB hard drive for the operating system and a 1TB external RAM on which the game is installed. As for operating system, we're using Windows X Lite Resto Revival version 2. You can find the full description of the specs in the video description down below. The game that we'll be benchmarking today is Pro Evolution Soccer 2017. A football game that who knows how many people want to see benchmarked on this channel. Shout out to the people who requested it, by the way. A quick note to make. Because the default settings menu has a restriction on Intel HD graphics where you can't increase the quality from low, and yes, I do want to test the game with higher quality too, because who knows, some people would want to play Pro Evolution Soccer 2017 with higher quality on their Celeron without minding playing at lower FPS. So instead, we're gonna be changing the graphics settings using the on-off selector and 4K enabler, which I will provide in the pinned comment. To use it, just extract it to your game directory, make sure to enter the password from the link page, after you're done modifying the game setting using the custom settings menu. If your game is pirated, make sure not to launch it from the on-off selector, but from the Pro Evolution Soccer 2017.exe file in your game directory. You can create separate shortcuts of both of them for better convenience. And that's pretty much it. Let's get straight to the point now.
Things running. Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today? It's got to be the little chief, Javier Mascherano. Uncompromising and ready to tackle anything that moves, and he does so with tenacity and grit. It shouldn't take long for him to make his mark.
Yeah, the scourge of so many strikers.
That's Sergio Busquets. Iniesta. Played out to the right. Through. That's gone a long way up and away. Throw it. Marcelo tries a through ball, has a swing at it. Superb goal! Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt, and here we are, early stages. He struck one, and he looks hungry for more.
Oh, you've got to say the odds missing from there were very slim. It's almost criminal to see a defence fail to identify someone who thrives when it comes to shooting stats. They knew, and yet they didn't heed, and they paid the price and deserved to. Big occasion, big goal, crucial lead. Across the globe. We should be on the way very shortly. The players will be with us any time now. I'm your commentator, Peter Drury, and providing his unique brand of expert analysis, here's Jim Beglin. Thanks for that, Peter. Hi, everyone. The excitement has really picked up now, and I'm eager for the action to start. Away we go then. Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today? It's got to be the little chief, Javier Mascherano. Uncompromising and ready to tackle anything that moves, and he does so with tenacity and grit. It shouldn't take long for him to make his mark.
Yeah, I must agree, especially in view of his ability to lead and organise the defence. Aimed long and direct. Now the pass. Shoots! Big moment! Massive goal!
And some of the best managers I played for insisted on starting games as you mean to go on. And we've just seen a very important opening goal from an extremely talented individual who looks primed for more. He really does look at it.
Returns to shoot. And he duly delivered.
It's almost criminal to see a defence fail to identify someone who thrives when it comes to shooting stats. They knew, and yet they didn't heed, and they've paid the
price. Of course it had to be Ronaldo.
Big occasion, big goal, crucial lead. Sergio Busquets. Rain starting to fall here. It has been looking that way for a little while. Piqué. Daniel Alves. Cristiano Ronaldo.
Across the globe. We should be on the way very shortly. The players will be with us any time now. This is Peter Drury, and next to me providing insights will be Jim Beglin.
Thanks, Peter. Hello, everybody. Ready to see what unfolds in this one now.
Business here. Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today?
Well, I'm going to go for a man who probably defines the anchor midfield role, Sergio Busquets. Responsible for maintaining the balance when either fullback moves forward, he can drop in at centre-back occasionally, and he gets him on the front foot with his crisp passing.
Yes, getting the best out of him will count for so much.
Has a pop!
That's a half-decent try.
Well, if he hopes to do better than that, he's got to work on his technique and his timing. The contact wasn't right there, so there wasn't much chance of success. Well, that should set them on their way and get into a nice rhythm. The early signs are very encouraging now.
Daniel Carvajal. He's making a foray down the right. Looks like a good ball through.
Oh, real chance!
Oh, the keeper's done ever so well.
I made that look really easy, Peter, but I can assure you that wasn't a routine save. He had to be very switched on there. It's Danny Alves. Now the pass. Messi looking to get on the end of this. Messi, Rakitic, could try cutting inside here. Luis Suarez, it's hit the upright. Great effort, beautifully taken.
Yeah, and he knew he had to get his efforts away before it had been closed down, but he could have sacrificed a little power then for a bit more accuracy.
Warmest of welcomes to you. We await the conclusion of the pre-game formalities. I'm Peter Drury, and it's a pleasure to be alongside Jim Begley. Glad to be here, Peter, and I'm ready to rumble. Whistle. Do you, Jim, see making a difference here?
Who else but Lionel Messi? I don't need to tell anyone what he's capable of. Some critics don't rate him as the best player on the planet. That's because the Argentinian, for me, is on a different planet.
Yeah, he'll be looking for a goal or two. Toni Kroos tries to get it forward quickly. Cristiano Ronaldo. Toni Kroos tries the route one option. Now it's Toni Kroos. Sergio Busquets. Daniel Alves. And it's Messi. Luis Suarez. A long pass out wide. Sergio Ramos. Cristiano Ronaldo. Mascherano cuts it out. Away from immediate danger. He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
The idea was good though, Peter. I like the run that triggered the pass, but the quality was the problem.
Suarez plays it out to the flank. Ball's loose. Who's getting there? Sergio Busquets gets it back. Now the cross. Barcelona are working the ball as only they can. Of welcomes to you. We await the conclusion of the pre-game formalities. This is Peter Drury, and I'm happy to inform you that Jim Beglin has joined me to offer his expertise.
Thanks for that, Peter. Hi, everyone. The excitement has really picked up now, and I'm eager for the action to start.
Out as the telling individual today.
It's hard to overlook Gerard Piqué. He should be given a bit more credit, I think, for his performances. Anticipates when...
And he's done it!
Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt, and here we are, early stages. He struck one, and he looks hungry for more. loved the finish, but I think had the pass been delayed for just a second longer, I think he would have been flagged offside. I think you have to praise them all round on that one, from the pass and the finish. Big occasion, big goal, crucial lead. Messi. Looks like a good ball through. Now it's Benzema. That'll be a corner. Toni Kroos with the short one. Cuts it back. And that's been repelled. That's not the cross he had in mind. Casemiro. Now it's Benzema. Out to the left it goes. Plenty waiting in the middle. Clearance now. Can they make something of it? Ball's loose. Who's getting there? Hello and welcome to all of our viewers from around the world. We have quite a game in prospect here. Just waiting for the players to emerge and we will be underway. I'm Peter Drury, and this is Jim Beglin. A delight to have him on board. Hello, Peter, and hello to everyone watching. For me, it's a real thrill to be here. And that gets things running. So, Jim, who would you identify as the key man in this fixture?
I've got to go for the highly talented Neymar, a player who's had a lot of pressure to contend with in living up to the great potential he showed from such a young age. That's made him stronger mentally for me, which backs up his immense ability.
Yeah, hard to see past him. He'll be looking to put on a show, I'm certain of that. Sergio Busquets, Rakitic, and it's Messi. Now it's Luis Suarez. Looks like a good ball through. Toni Kroos gets it back. Doesn't get the pass he's looking for. Pepe. All the way back and they start again. Sergio Ramos, Marcelo, Kroos, it's long and forward, he could have been in, just needed a better final ball.
Yeah, I think the problem there was that the pass was telegraphed, an easy read for the defence.
Fires it in low. Out to the left it goes. Now it's Luis Suarez. Barcelona are working the ball as only they can.
To you all, we will be underway very shortly once all the pleasantries are complete. I'm Peter Drury, and seated in the expert's hot seat is our man Jim Beglin.
Thanks for that, Peter, and may I say a big hello to everyone.
Ooh.
it's down to business here.
Jim, who do you pick out as the telling individual today?
Well, it's a tough one, but I'll go for Dani Alves, just to point out that he masquerades as a fullback. You know, he'll spend so much of the game deep in opposition territory, playing like a winger. Tremendous fitness and athleticism, and that enables him to perform this way.
Yeah, I must agree, especially in view of his ability to lead and organise the defence. It's Cristiano Ronaldo, played out to the wing. Benzema, he's onside. Cristiano Ronaldo, unable to make it happen for all his good intentions. Managed to get it away. Messi, Daniel Alves, looking to get on the end of this. He's made sure that that won't get through. Sergio Busquets. Barcelona are experts at this stylish possession-based game.
Well, we're talking tiki-taka. A lot of short, crisp passing, and once the ball is lost, they quickly try to win it back.
Decent progress down the left. Cristiano Ronaldo with the challenge, and he has given away a free kick. Welcome to you all. We will be underway very shortly once all the pleasantries are complete. I'm Peter Drury and this is Jim Beglin. A delight to have him on board.
Thanks for that, Peter, and may I say a big hello to everyone.
Things running. Jim, which player is best equipped for this game?
I've got to go for the highly talented Neymar, a player who's had a lot of pressure to contend with in living up to the great potential he showed from such a young age. That's made him stronger mentally for me, which backs up. Goal! Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt. Here we are, early stages. He struck one and he looks hungry for more.
He was never going to miss from there.
Well, for me, that's just pure predatory brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation when nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
Big occasion. Big goal, crucial lead. All the way back and they start again. Ter Stegen gets it upfield. Oh, well intercepted, really alert to the danger. Done very well to intervene. Iniesta. And it's Jordi Alba. Jordi Alba looking for options. He's making good use of his strength there, just refuses to be out-muscled. Sergio Busquets, spooned forward. Benzema pushes it out wide. He'll have a dip! And the keeper's relieved to see that disappear wide.
And that was more than a decent attempt, perhaps it deserved better too.
Welcome to you all. We will be on the way very shortly, once all the pleasantries are complete. I'm your commentator, Peter Drury, and providing his unique brand of expert analysis, here's Jim Beglin.
Glad to be here, Peter, and I'm ready to rumble.
Through.